your feet on the floor. And if it's possible, lift the toes a little bit first and try to feel your heels and the ball of your foot, and then spread your toes on the floor. Okay? So ground your feet first. Then go with your awareness to your lower back, to your hips, try to ground. Maybe the belly, not forcing the belly in, but a little bit the belly in just to help the lower back to go into the floor. And lengthen the spine. Bring, remember the chin toward the chest. And then spread and open your arms. Yeah? And just start to settle on the mat. Good. Now remember, you already were here before. Yeah. So imagine that you reconnect with the energy and the roots that we put in place on the past classes. Yeah. Rachel is the second time for you, but imagine that you reconnect with the energy that you put on Monday. Yeah? And soften. Imagine that you are connecting on the breathe out with those roots. Or if you prefer, always you can imagine that you release your roots today from your body into the floor. And imagine creating a huge base with your roots, net or a web. And you allow yourself to start to relax on those roots. And the roots are expanding and connecting with the planet, with the resilience and strength and the stillness of the planet inside, but also imagine that you connect with all the resources or the nourishment that the planet has to offer. So imagine that you start to breathe in all that into your body, into your mind, into your heart. And as always, imagine when you come into this room that the room is filled with a beautiful, loving, caring energy, a pink light. So imagine that you are breathing in that light as well. So with each breathing, you receive the energy from above, the energy from the planet. Imagine all that energy combined is moving through your body, melting, dissolving the tension, the tightness, stress, worries, any pain, any discomfort. And imagine that you release all that into the roots, and the roots also starting to act as a recycle center where you will have your own energy cleanse and purify. So you breathe back even your own energy. Yeah? So you have like a three resources of energy filling yourself. Yeah? The energy above, the energy of the planet, and your own energy that is transformed. So with all that in mind, we will bring really gentle one leg toward your belly. Now when you cut, so don't tense to bring the leg closer, just let your arms fluffy and the leg will come closer, yeah, for the weight of your arms. Yeah? So when you breathe out, you let the leg go to your belly. And as you feel that you are straightening, lengthening the back of the neck. Good. Now we will open the knee to the side. Yeah? So move the knee out. You catch the foot and the leg, the foot and the knee. And again, press your leg toward your belly, relax your back, keep surrendering with your back into the floor. Relaxing your shoulder blades, relaxing your elbows. And then we stretch the leg up, comfy. And we move the leg a little side to side. Not too big, yeah? So soft, So we feel the lower back. Cool. And then move the leg like a crossing over you, trying to keep the hip a little bit on the floor. So not too much, like a twist. Keep the hip, bring the leg soft. Yes? So we stretch a little bit this area. You can even, if you like, put the hand on the leg, but keeping the grounding. Soften the leg. Yeah? And then coming back to the center, and we move the foot in circles. And flexing and stretching. Good. Now we put that leg on the floor and we catch the other leg. Yes, so soften here, bring the belly, the leg toward the belly, relax your shoulder blades, relax your elbows, lengthen the back of the neck. Yeah? So always the chin trying to go to your chest or to the base of your neck, keeping the head on the floor. And then we bring the leg up, soft, sorry, forgot, bring the knee out, bring the knee out. So put the leg open, hand on the knee, hand on the foot, and let your hip relax there. Yes, soften your shoulders. Like you want to put the whole of your back nice and spreading on the floor. Very nice. Now we stretch the leg and we move the leg side to side, keeping the hips on the floor. Yes, so the movement is just to make you feel the lower back. And then we stay with the leg crossing over. Try to keep the hip grounding. We are also stretching the lower back. Yeah? When you stretch the lower back, you are creating a space for the nerves that sense a nice feeling on the legs as well. Yeah? Feeling of release on the muscles. Now we move the foot in circles. And then we put the leg over the other leg, and in this position, we bring the legs towards you. So we move side to side. Again, shoulders away. So don't force the legs towards you, just move softly. And then we do like a circle in this position. And then relax, and we go with the other leg, first side to side. And then we roll in circles, yeah? And then both legs, side to side. Good. And then we roll toward one side. And we go to all fours. Yeah. So. Toward the end of the class, we will do another release for this part. Yeah. So shoulders away. Nice and comfy, and we move. Now remember to open the fingers as much as you can. Eh? So breathing forward, breathe out back. Good, very nice. And then we go to the opposite direction. Go. And then, relax in the shoulder blades, relax your belly and your lower back. Yes, so just let your back arch without forcing the arch, and just let like your belly heavy falling and your lower back. And then to round, start like through your belly, squeeze the lower belly, like the place close to your pubic bone. Imagine that you want to squeeze that part and round, releasing the head and the neck, checking that your shoulders are not squeezing to your ears. Yes, so separate it far away from your ears. Squeeze the lower belly, not all, like a tensing, just this part if you can. We are working on the pelvic floor as well, and the lower back. So we relax on the breathing, and on the breathe out, squeezing through like the pubic bone, relax your neck, relax your head. So you do it in your own rhythm, following your breath. But try to do it really slow, if you can, to bring your awareness there. Good. And then we put the toes, we put the back of the toes on the floor, expanding, open, and then squeeze, and round. And again, breathing, expanding, open, and then squeeze. And one more time, breathing, expanding, open, and squeeze. Well done. Now we open the knees and we go to child pose. So we soften with the shoulders away. If you're gonna ride to the floor, you can put your hands beneath your forehead. So comfy back, relax the elbows on the floor, that bring the shoulder blades more comfy to relax. Soften, let go. Using the image of the roots, imagine that you are surrendering all your tension into the roots to be recycled. All the stress or worries, anything that could be bothering you, imagine that you decide to let it go. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And coming back to the center, we go to all fours, again with the shoulders away from your ears, and we roll in circles the upper back, trying to lift in the shoulder blades up and then release in the chest. So try to feel the shoulder blades are moving down and then moving up, but with the shoulders separated from your ears. Yeah? Now we go to the other side. Good. And then we bring one arm underneath the other arm. We put the shoulder, we put the head, and we soften. Let it go. Surrendering. And then we coming back to the center. And we relax. and release. And we will go to downward facing dog. Okay, so in your own time, try to start with the legs bending. So you can start to ground your hands and work back with your hips, softening your head. Try to move a little bit side to side so it doesn't feel too tense or too stiff. Very nice, very nice. Relax. Soft. And then we start to work on the legs, like walking on the spot, trying to relax the heels one by one toward the floor, but don't worry if you don't touch it. Just trying to feel the back of your calf stretch. Good. And then we try with both. Yes, sorry, here you go. So we will go to plank. Yes, so we bring the shoulders above the hands, trying to lengthen from the crown of the head to your heels, and the hips a little bit tilting forward. And then to go to downward facing dog, hips out, and we go back, and we expand wherever is possible. We do one more, only one more. So plank, heels stays back, the head lengthen forward, shoulders away, and expand, open, 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 open. Relax, well, very nice. So we'll put the knees on the floor, and we will work with one leg. Yes, so again, shoulders away, expanding, and then rounding again with the same idea, squeezing the lower belly, bringing the head toward the knee and the knee toward the head, and then expand. Very nice. So in your own time, soft, soft but big. And one more time, we stay with the knee forward, squeezing a little bit the belly, rounding. Stay there a little bit. Ah, relax, we go with the other leg. So, expanding and rounding. Breathing open. And rounding, squeezing the lower belly. Breathing open and round. And one more time. Good, well done. So we'll put one leg forward. I start with this so you can see. So we relax forward a little bit first. And then try to do the same. Try to lift in the toes to feel the heel and the ball of your foot, and then press your toes. And then relax your hips. Okay? So belly in, lengthening up, shoulders away, and we expand, softening, okay? Relaxing hips, open. Very nice. Well done. So without forcing, keeping this nice and long with the belly a little bit in, we will put the hand, the opposite hand on the leg, and we will rotate. Shoulders away and send your hips more forward. Yeah? So imagine that you want to open the groin of the back leg, yeah, toward the floor. Expand. Yeah? These rotations, when we are in this position, also stretch the side. Yeah? Well done. And then coming back, we can put the hands on the legs or on the blocks. And we go slowly, hips out. Or you can always put, if you don't have blocks, you can put one hand on the leg without pushing the knee, okay? Sorry, I look a little bit weird looking this end. Imagine that there is two or three people more here on where is the camera. Good. Expand. Good. And then we change. Yeah, we put the other leg. So again, position yourself, yeah? And then do like an extra grounding with the feet, so the foot. So ground the ball of your foot and then your toes. And then pressing with your body. Yeah? So relax the hip forward. We want to stretch this groin. Yeah? This muscle is the one that is all the time contracted because we are sitting a lot. Well, now we are moving a little bit more, but we were a lot sitting. Yeah? So spread. Lengthen your spine, lengthen your arms without tensing. Keep falling with your hips. Open the groin. And then we will put the hands on the leg. We keep the leg in line and we rotate the spine. Shoulders away. Softly, yeah, don't force it. Yeah? Good. Keep the belly, the center of the belly in and the solar plexus up. Shoulders relaxing. Keep relaxing the hip forward. And then coming back. And again, hands on the floor or on the blocks. Or we can go a little bit to the side and put the hand on the leg to make it more comfortable. Okay, so hips out now, the opposite. Don't force the kneecap. Even if you can, the knee always a little bit bending. And we push with the hips back. And then we go forward. We bring the second leg. And expanding and open. Yeah. So again, we do a little bit of that, lifting the toes and connecting the ball of your foot, then your toes. Check that your knees are not tensing back, the knees are soft, not bending, like the kneecap a little bit more loose. Yeah. And pressing to the feet, imagine that you're connecting with the roots. And imagine that you're receiving the energy as you breathe, and as you receive the energy, you want to expand your body to bring that energy to the whole of yourself. Okay? So imagine the sole of your feet open, receiving the energy. Okay? Imagine a tree that is receiving the nourishment from the roots. So imagine that we are capable to do the same, okay? To have the same skill. And then we go to the side, soft. Remember, not tense here. Keep the knees soft, your shoulder blades and shoulders soft as well. And then we go to the other side. Now we will bend a little bit more deeply the legs. Okay? And imagine that you will press into the floor to receive more energy, like you take an impulse and then spread to the side without going into tension. And then bending, and we go to the other side, spreading the sole of your feet, yeah? Shoulders away. And then coming up, one more time. Spreading, yeah? Shoulders away. Relax, release. So we will go to the top of the mat. Yeah. So breathing, expand again. The feet, yeah, connected, open. Imagine that you're lifting from the feet and from the arms. Yeah, collecting all the energy. The energy is going in, and then as we go down, hips out, belly, solar plexus, chest. Head and arms, imagining that going down on the breathe out, we are releasing all the tension to the roots. Yeah? So we stay a little bit there just to let your body expand, your neck, shoulders, your legs are comfy. And then we will put the hands on your shins, we look up, so bum is out, chest open, head up. Shoulders away, we put the hands on the floor, we go back to plank. Good. Lengthen your plank, hips a little bit tilting forward. Knees on the floor, you can stay all fours, or we go to upward facing dog, bending elbows closer to your body, belly in, expanding. Open shoulders away, lengthen the back of the neck, relaxing your groins, but without going to the floor. Yeah, so you are on your arms. And then hips out, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, and heels. Well done. Beautiful. We bring the right leg forward. We go to warrior two. Grounding here. Settle. So once you settle, again, do that little connection of your foot. Imagine that you are touching the accelerator of the car. That will be the idea. So when you press, you are bringing energy. Yeah? Keep the knee, remember the knee, and again, relax the hip. So remember not going to the knee, the arch of your foot active. Relax your arms, spread, settle. Yeah? And imagine that you are absorbing energy. We put the arm on the front leg, open from the hip, yeah, the upper body, neck, head, and we're lifting the arm. Very nice, yeah? Well done. And again, keep the knee open, yeah? And spread like the solar plexus. Yeah, open there. Well done. Good. Coming up, pressing into the front leg. Imagine that you are receiving energy. Yeah? And settle again. Knee open. Shoulders away. Don't force the arch, even if you can. Yeah? And then coming back. Connecting. We rotate. Back to plank. Shoulders away, yeah? And again, chest and chin, slowly, belly in, expand, sorry. Spread, shoulders back, yeah? We go hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, heels. And we bring the left leg forward. Yeah? Oh, taking your time. So again, first settle, yeah? Yeah. Then do the toes, check that the knee is not going to the center, settle, spread, yeah. Relax your hips. We will put the arm, we open hip, belly, chest, neck, head, arm. Yeah. Soften the shoulder blade, yeah, keep going. Bring the hand a little bit more forward. Ah, there we are. And then from here. Yeah. So check the discomfort here. Beautiful. Well done, coming up. Spread back, back, back. Keep relaxing. Keep the knee open. Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Beautiful. Settle. Rotate. Back to plank. Shoulders away. And we go. So all fours, if you have shoulder pain, eh? Belly in, expanding, open, lengthen the back of the neck, and then hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head. We bring the legs forward toward the hands, and we go all the way up, expanding. Ah, relax, yeah? We do it one more time, breathing open. Receiving, eh? And then imagine that you let go the tension, release, receiving again, breathing open, put the tension on the floor, plank, good. We go forward one more time, yeah? So remember, if you have a pain on the shoulders, do all fours only, yeah? Expanding, controlling the movement. We go up, hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, heels. Beautiful, well done. We bring the right leg forward. We will go again to warrior two. And we will go to triangle, okay? So keep the knee open, yeah? So remember, the arch of your foot here, nice and active. That will bring the knee in place. If you let the arch fall, the knee falls. Yeah, we will go to triangle, pushing the thigh back, lengthening the legs but not tensing, a little bit of softness. Now when you do that, when you bring the leg back, bring the hip in, don't go this way, yeah? So check, 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 and forward, and then rotate. Imagine that you enter in a channel, and then put the hand on the leg. And then from the hip, open, and then your arm. Shoulders away, keep the hips in. Very nice, very nice. Open chest, yeah, beautiful. Bring them a little bit, the hand a little bit more forward here, this way. So, here, yes, yes. And then from here, ah, there we are. Yeah, beautiful. Bending, sorry, bending the front leg. Coming up, coming up, coming up. Warrior two. Well done. We rotate, squeeze, back to plank. Cool. So we do a little more today. We do a little bit of shock to the system. Expand, shoulders back. So relaxing your groins, but without relaxing the whole lot. Belly in. We go up. And then left leg forward, warrior two. Yeah. So we will press the thigh back. Remember not to block the kneecap. Yeah. So back, 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 back. And when we go back, we bring the hip in. We go forward, rotate. So you rotate from the hip. We put the hand and then we keep rotating and then you accommodate the arm up. Yes, don't force, beautiful. Well done, well done. So, solar, yes, perfect. There, that's the position. Now, just the chest open. Ah, there we are. You see the difference on the shoulder? Beautiful. Bending the front leg, well done. Coming back. Chuk, 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 chuk. Back. One more, the last one. Yeah, we can do it, come on. One more, expanding belly, shoulders away. Breathe out, push. Open, 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 open. Shoulders relaxing. And we bring the legs forward. And expand, go. Last one, breathing open. Connecting, expanding, receiving. And then when you breathe out, you're releasing. Good. Breathing, expanding. Blank. Shoulders away. And we go again. Chest and chin. Belly in. Expanding. Lengthen the back of the neck. Don't force the head up because that tends your shoulders. We go up, open. So we will bring the right leg forward. This time we go to warrior one. Yes, so we face the hips facing forward. Yeah. So rotate the hips and accommodate the back foot. Yeah, don't stay with the foot all twisted. Yeah, comfortable. And again. Your knee to the center, yeah, check the arch, rotate, expand, yeah, good, shoulders away. So keep relaxing the hip forward without going arching, yeah? Keep lengthening here, good. So from there, we will put the hands. Now, if you need, you can turn, put the toes of the back leg. You can do it with the whole foot or just the toes. Yeah, and we will lengthen up and we will rotate first, like we did on the floor, yeah? So rotate and then you go down, if you like, yeah? We don't have to, so you can stay wherever the rotation is okay for you, yeah? Yes, that's part of the pose, eh? The balance, yeah, yeah, yeah. So try to open the chest, yeah? And keep the heel back and this up. That will give the balance of the position. Yeah. Keep, 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 keep. Coming back. Coming back, coming back. If you're lifting the heel, put it back on the floor and expand. Lengthen, yeah? Remember not to arch. Spread. This super open chest. Yeah, receiving all the energy that you need. Soften, relax, back to plank. Almost there, last one, last one, last one. Breathing open. Open, shoulders away. We go back. Spread. We bring the left leg forward, warrior one. Connecting. So, I know, almost there. So rotate, comfy on the ankle of the second leg, yeah? Grounding, relax your hips, yeah? Lengthen this part. When you catch this, try to check that you open. Yeah? Good. Now, you check if you can do it with the foot or you go into the toes. If you go into the toes, lifting the thigh up. Connecting there, connecting the bone. We rotate. And then you check if you can go lower or just stay there. We don't need to force, beautiful. Open chest. Breathing deeply, yes, yeah, that's perfect. That's part of the pose, yeah? Yeah, don't worry. Yeah. And then coming back. Put the back foot again. Ground and breathe. Settle a little bit more, shoulders, relax, open. Back to plank, well done, eh? Well done, ladies. Ah, chest and chin, belly in, expand, shoulders back, lengthening the back of the neck, we go up. Stay a little bit on the downward facing dog. Now that you are more warm, yeah. Expand, yeah? Work there on open the chest. Very nice. Relax your head and then try to relax your heels. Soften. Good. And then we relax. And we go to child pose. Yay. Soften. So hands could be on the front or beneath your forehead or beside your body. Soften. Relax your shoulder blades. Good. And then relax, release. Well done. Now we will stay in hero pose. If it's possible, I promise a nice shavasana. Promise. So hero pose or sitting on the position. Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Take your time. Grounding, or on the heels or on the blocks. Yeah. We can do it, Gail. Yeah. So grounding it. Check the bone and press. So we do a couple of breaths. Pressing into the bone to lifting again the solar plexus. Yeah? So instead of thinking on open the chest, thinking in lifting the solar plexus, that will put the spine in place and doesn't tense. I know. I did it on purpose so you generate heat to spread a little bit. So sorry. Promise next class we will do it less. So lifting here. Good. Now soften your shoulders, open your arms, check that you are not tensing here. Yeah? So we do two or three movements here, just checking that you don't activate the shoulder joint, just the arms. Yeah? Good. Now we will stay. Imagine at the same time that your hands are open. Imagine that you have lungs or nose or mouth on the hands catching energy or a hole. Yeah. So we will move. Imagine that you are like a satellite dish. Yeah, receiving signals. That's energy. Yeah. At some point when you start to bring the awareness to the palm of your hands, you will start to feel like energy feel on the palm. Yeah, that's the receiving of energy. So we will stay with one open again here. We will put the hand on the side of the head and we relax the neck. Don't force it, soften. And this hand could be or hanging or on your leg, but keep the solar plexus active. No forcing, just softening. Breathing softly. Now we will put the hand behind the head. Open a little bit more. This hand goes behind now. Now when you put this hand, check the shoulder. So you bring it back and then the last bit back. So you have this sensation of opening here. Yeah? So now with the shoulder falling forward. Cool. And then you stay. We will put the hand again on the side. And we spread a little bit more your neck softly. Yeah? And then relax, release. We go softly with the other arm, taking your time. Check that you are not lifting the shoulder. Keep the shoulders down. We put the hand on the side of the head. We move slowly, really gentle, so we don't come back to contract the one that we already stretched. Keep the solar plexus open. And then put the hand behind, spread without tensing it, and bring the hand behind again, the same idea, back and then down. Here you want to feel this nice and separate. Good. And then again, the head on the side. And then relax. Here we put the arms for a moment on the legs, shoulders away. And imagine breathing like from above, from the crown of your head, an energy that is scanning for all the tension that you discovered during the other poses. And imagine that you're sending that to the roots, to the recycle. And with the palms of your hands, you are still imagining that you are breathing through your hands as well. Now imagine that you have energy on your hands, yeah? Even if you don't feel anything yet, doesn't matter. We will put the hands, imagine that you have all that beautiful energy on your hands. We will put the hands behind your head. Now lifting the solar plexus, so don't round in this position, and keep this active. We will bring the chin toward the chest and only move the neck, so not the back, just the neck. So you keep pushing with your hips, lifting the solar plexus and the chin toward the chest, close your elbows and pull, in this one, pull a little bit your head toward the chest. So you will feel, obviously the stretching on the neck, but you could feel on the middle of the back a point on the spine that is pulling, if you don't round the back, yeah? So keep the spine straight, pulling with the chest up and bring the head. That point that you feel on the middle of the back is the insertion of those chunky muscles that we have on the back that are always contracted. Yeah? Don't worry if you don't feel it either. Eh? Relax. Ah, soften. Again, let the hands relax there. And another set of breathing, absorbing energy from above, releasing. Sending all the tension that you discover to the floor. Good. Now taking your time, we put the hands on the floor and we stretch your legs. Ay, 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 ay. Stretch. Good. Well, very nice. And we will lying down on the floor now, on the back. Now, before you go completely so you don't have to move the head, you stay there. We will work, when we lie in down, the hips, we will try to put the hips tilting forward. Yes, so we will do this, Chuck, squeezing here, and we will try to put the lower back nice and connected on the floor. And in this position, we will go to bridge, yeah? So we take your time, lying down. Now spread, you take your time, feel your feet connected, feel your hip, expand your spine, the back of the neck, your arms. Lengthen. Yeah? Take a moment just to relax on the floor. Connecting with your breathing. So when you breathe in, imagine that we start to receive energy from the whole of the front of your body, not only your nose. Yeah? The body is receiving energy, hands. Yeah? And on the breathe out, you surrender to the floor. Now, as you start to expand, check if you can bring the hips a little bit tilting forward, the belly in, but not tensing that you can breathe. Yeah? It's a middle tension there. Just the belly close to your pubic bone. Yeah, imagine that that is in and press with your lower back on the floor. Check if you can spread your spine a little bit more. And then using that grounding of the feet, we push into the floor and we're lifting the groins up, the thighs up, with your hips still tilting forward, yes? So your belly's in, so you go with the thighs and the groins, going into the back of the neck. Okay, and press into the feet to keep helping your groins to go up, yeah? We want to stretch the hip flexor there. Cool. Stay as long as feels okay. And then relax, release. Soften, relax. More. Now, we will do one bridge without doing anything with your hips. Yeah? So don't tilt the hips forward, just normal. Yeah. And do a bridge. Just, I want that you feel, if you can feel the difference between one and the other. There is anything wrong with both, eh? Both are okay, just you can feel, you can even relax your bone there to feel the lower back not connected. And then you can squeeze again the hips and the belly and the bone. Yeah? Just to feel the difference on the feelings on the lower back and the hips. And then relax, release, well done. Very nice. Now we will put the feet together now. And we will relax in that position. Yeah? Now, again, check if you can bring the hips again tilting forward to bring the lower back as much as you can toward the floor. This position, naturally, you will tend to arch the lower back. Yeah? So you do a little effort first to put the lower back on the floor. Lengthening the spine, yeah? Chin toward the chest. And then relax your legs and relax your back. Yeah? So your back will tend to arch. That's okay. But at least we started with a nice long spine. Soften your inner thighs. Don't force the open, just soften. And again, imagine that you are receiving energy from the whole of the body, including your legs, your inner thighs, and your hands. Yeah? Feel the palms of your hands open there to receive energy. Surrender. Don't force it. Now, could be that you don't feel comfortable on the inner thighs start to shake a little, that's okay. Try to breathe and imagine that you send the breathing into the thighs as well. Now slowly, we will close. And then we will put the feet using the width of the mat. Yeah? So put the feet nice and open on the side. Yes, perfect. Your knees are still bending, okay? So what we will do is now we will bring the thighs together. Yeah. Now we don't need to force your knees or whatever feels okay for your thighs and your knees. Yeah. And again, the same action, bring the belly in and the lower back toward the floor. Yeah. Cool. Very nice. And try to send also, if it's possible, the solar plexus like in that position. Yeah. So imagine, Rachel, you keep going. Can I touch you? So imagine that you can close as well to really flatten your back. Yeah, this is for that part. Eh? Cool. Now we open the knees. You keep the opening of the feet, so you don't move the feet. And we will go with one leg to the center, but we keep the other knee facing up, so you can feel a nice stretch here. And then we open, and then we bring the other leg down. Yeah. And at the same time, check if you can press in the belly and the lower back toward the floor to increase the opening of that, the side of the leg muscles. Yeah. So we go, and then change. So you can do it moving, chak chak, and then the other leg. Or you can decide to stay a long time with one leg and then with the other leg. So go with the feeling here, what brings you more comfort or more release. Yeah. Keeping the belly in and the lower back toward the floor. Don't go too low so your knee is not forced. Yeah. And one more time. And then relax, well done. We bring the knees to your belly. We soften side to side. Relaxing. And then we go to one side. Bending your knees. Going into a spinal twist. Relaxing your shoulder blades, relaxing your arms. Softening, very nice. And now recover the image of the loving energy around you, yeah, the pink light. Imagine the energy beneath you, yeah, the roots absorbing all the nourishing energy that you need. So imagine that now you have a lot of free space in your body. Imagine that we let it go, the tension that we're carrying, and now you fill those spaces with a more supple, more comfortable energy. And then to the other side, yeah, taking your time. Soften, shoulders away, relax. And then coming back to the center, and we go to Shavasana. Yeah, so nice and comfy. Yeah, good. You can put, if you need, home blankets. Good. Very nice. Yeah, take your time. So imagine slowly that you start to bring that energy, the pink light, the loving energy, the caring energy, protective energy into your body with each breathing. And from above, from beneath, the energy that the roots are catching from the planet. And we can imagine that we put all together in one beam of energy. Imagine that you will create with all those energy a channel or a beam that goes into your feet. Yeah. So imagine the sole of your feet open like a big pipe, ready to receive this combination of energies. And as this energy is moving through your body, you will receive a really nice relaxation, a feeling of peace and comfort. So imagine that energy ready on the sole of your feet, moving up to your toes, and then to the top of your feet, your ankles, and then your lower legs, your knees, your thighs, and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine that energy moving through your shoulders, through your arms, your hands, your fingers, and then going up through your wrists, elbows, shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly. And allow your body to surrender completely to the floor. And going deeply inside now. And relax, relax, relax. Now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there we fall to one side, bending your knees. We go to a sitting position. If you like, place your hands on your legs, your arms on the legs with the palms facing up. And again, imagine that you still have that idea of the hands breathing and receiving energy. And you can use this idea during your day, yeah, when you need to recharge. And bring your hands now to your belly or to your chest or one and one. And imagine that you are saving that ability to breathe peace and nourishment at any moment, yes, through your body, through your hands, through your normal breath. And give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to come to class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.